welcome to all our viewers and welcome to a new episode of Africa Today, where we bring you all the latest news and events happening across the African continent. And of course, a very happy Eid al-Adha to all our viewers, to all Muslims all around the world. Now, starting, of course, straight away after performing the Eid al-Adha prayer and attending to sacrifice, millions across Egypt continue to celebrate the holidays in public parks, taking boat rides in the Nile, and visiting zoos, as well as going to movie theaters. Eid al-Adha is one of the two major religious holidays of the Islamic calendar. We have more details in this report, and we'll be right back, so do stay tuned.
Eid al-Adha, also known the Festival of the Sacrifice, is the second of two Islamic holidays celebrated worldwide each year, the other being Eid al-Fitr, and considered the holier of the two. It honors the willingness of Ibrahim to sacrifice his son as an act of obedience command. But before Ibrahim could sacrifice his son, God provided a lamb to sacrifice instead. In commemoration of this intervention, an animal is sacrificed and divided into three parts. One share is given to the poor and needy, another is kept for home, and the third is given to relatives. Eid al-Adha falls for the 10th day of Zulhijjah and lasts for 3 days. Devotees offer the Eid al-Adha prayers at the mosque. The Eid al-Adha prayer is performed any time after the sun completely rises up to just before the entering of Zuhr time. On the 10th of Zulhijjah, at conclusion of the prayers and sermon, Muslims embrace and exchange greetings with one another, Eid Mubarak, give gifts and visit one another. Many Muslims also take this opportunity to invite their non-Muslim friends, neighbors, co-workers and classmates to their Eid festivals to better acquaint them about Islam and Muslim culture.
And of course, the Eid al-Adha celebrations, the day begins with the morning prayers, and the celebrations continue for 3 days, where visits to friends and families and exchange of gifts, as well as the holding of feasts. Those who can afford also slaughter an animal like a cow or a sheep and share the meat with the less fortunate. We have more details in this report and we'll be right back, to stay tuned.
Africa is home to over 5 million people who follow the Islamic faith, with Middle East and North Africa region having the highest concentration of Muslim worldwide. The majority of the continent Muslims live in North, West and East Africa, with over 90% of the population in Algeria, Libya, Mauritania, Egypt, Djibouti, Gambia, Senegal, Morocco, Niger, Sudan, Somalia and Tunisia following the Islamic faith. Over 70% of the Nigerian population is Muslim, and Ethiopia, Kenya, and South Africa, Muslims account for 50%, 33%, and 3% of the population, respectively. Eid begins early in the morning with prayer and a sermon at mosque, followed by celebrations and family. Preparations for Eid begins early in the morning with the father of the household slaughtering a sheep, as per the Islamic customs, and women of the household preparing food the night before. Eid celebrations across South Africa vary from family to family and from city to city. Usually when Eid commences, men go to mosque for prayer and afterwards the family gathers for breakfast. Socializing and gift-giving to children commences after breakfast, and everyone is dressed in their best clothes as part of the celebration.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm now delighted to be joined over the telephone by my guest for this afternoon, Dr. Rauf Ghafar. A very good afternoon to you, sir.
Good afternoon to you, my dear.
Dr. Rauf, a very happy Eid to you and your family.
Same to you and yours, of course.
Thank you very much. Now, Doctor, millions of Muslims all over the world are celebrating Eid al-Adha. Tell us more a bit about this feast of sacrifice and what it means for Muslims worldwide.
Well, as we all know, the Feast of Sacrifice goes back to the Prophet Abraham when he was asked to slaughter his son Ismail, and then he was sacrificed. He was willing to do it, but God asked him to go for a sheep or something instead. And this was since. A ritual, this is mentioned, of course, in the Quran, the story is mentioned in full details, and it became a habit to, not a habit, but a must, as we say, in the Eid al-Adha, to do the same and sacrifice. Well, it can be a sheep, it can be a cow, it can be a camel, anything. I mean, just to perform the ritual that has been performed over the centuries since Islam was there. So it is, of course, goes without saying that this is the Hajj season, and this is one of the pillars of Islam.
Yes.
And so the Adha feast comes very much in the Hajj season. So the celebration is I should say, double. People are celebrating Hajj. The ones that are lucky to have a place to go to Hajj, and the others in their own home.
Dr. Raouf, in your opinion, how do you think such occasions like Eid and festivities bring communities closer together?
Beautiful. I mean, this is the one of a few, very few occasions that brings families together, that brings friends together. And this is something, especially nowadays, we have forgotten about it. I mean, I'm sorry to say that, but the family ties are no longer as they were maybe decades ago. So now we all grab such opportunities to see our families, to spend time with them, etc., etc. On the other hand, we hear beautiful news. Like this year, for instance, I'm very happy that our neighbors and brothers in Libya, for instance, they have negotiated and reached a truce. To stop a ceasefire over the Eid al-Adha period, which marks a beautiful thing. I mean, peace is a wonderful thing, and it has been absent from Libya for some time. So when one hears that they have come to the agreement of stopping the atrocities and the fighting for at least 3 or 4 days, gives us hope that they might stay maybe in this position longer, and maybe they take the opportunity of such festive season and maybe negotiate a longer
truce, ceasefire,
and maybe this will lead them to a final negotiations leading to peace to our country. So these are the kind of things that are one is happy to hear, of course.
Indeed.
So this is again, but we go back to the subject. Yes, it is very much a beautiful occasion to get together with friends, with family, and spend time together wherever we are. So this is very important, and we have a meal together. We spend the lovely times together, and this is really needed in this
During this day and age, indeed.
Yes.
Dr. Raouf, as you are our expert on African affairs, tell us a bit how the celebrations of Eid al-Adha are similar amongst the different African countries and differ from region to region in the African continent.
I tell you. First of all, let's divide the African countries into, for instance, Arab African countries like Libya, Tunisia, Morocco, Algeria, and probably they're all similar. Same thing, they go up early in the morning, go for the Al-Adha prayers, for the Eid prayers, and then they come back and watch the slaughtering of the sacrifice, and then they distribute the part of it to the poor. So this, again, is a sign of compassion between the rich and the poor. So one of the good things about the Eid is that people feel the need of others, and so this is important.
And provide for the less fortunate.
Down south a little bit in the African countries, in which Muslims constitute either a majority or even minority. Like this year, for instance, in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, we have seen a big importance given to the Eid al-Adha, and we have seen hundreds of thousands of Muslim Ethiopians performing the Hajj, the Eid prayers in different mosques and squares, etc., etc., and then they started to perform the sacrifice, etc., etc. So this is again nice. Sometimes one of the things I read about the rituals that take place in some of the African countries, particularly in South Africa, after the prayers, and particularly in the poor areas, a lot of the institutions, a lot of charity institutions, they donate. Sheep, sometimes cows, and say in big numbers, and they slaughter them in public, and everybody watches the act, and then they start distributing their meat on the needy people in the areas, etc., etc. So this again is a nice ritual that is performed in some of the African countries.
Indeed. Dr. Raouf, how do you explain some of the near identical traditions in different African countries, even those that don't have a majority of a Muslim population, but they all have similar cultural identities? For example, Eid, always there's the distribution of sweets and gifts and the giving of money to children, for example, and presents. Yes. How do you explain this?
By definition, Eid is a festival. I mean, and people deserve to be happy. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, a lot of countries don't have the privilege, I should say, or the luxury of peace and happiness all over the year. So this comes as a short but useful time where people enjoy peace, enjoy seeing each other and expressing their love and compassion to each other. Mm-hmm. So the important thing is to keep the tradition going and not let the technology and the new busy world take us from keeping to these, I see, very nice traditions. And as you rightly said, the young girls and boys, they look forward to receive their, what we call, hadiya, or a small amount of money from their parents and grandparents, and they go and buy themselves sweets. Maybe they go to fun fairs and enjoy plays. And so, I mean, it is a festivity time. People need this break. Even if they have in stable countries, they need to forget about work, to forget about responsibilities, and just take a very few days to enjoy life, to enjoy love and friendship and neighborhoodship, etc., with their friends and neighbors. So this is very, very important, and I stress on the fact that people should keep to such nice tradition. Mm-hmm.
Dr. Raouf, yes. do you see now with the new age and technology and the new media and how it's taking over a lot of people's lives, do you see these traditions as dwindling? Do you see families becoming smaller, maybe traveling on their own during Eid instead of being with their extended families? Do you see a change in that culture?
Most unfortunate, most unfortunate. Mm. I mean, there is a saying that the new internet and the new technology, they bring the far people
closer. Near. Yes, and, it's a global village, then, like
and
they say.
And the near people, they go far. It means that we can be in touch with our friends in maybe different countries miles away. And in the same time, not see our friends and family that are living next door. Mm-hmm. So this again, and then instead of going and visiting family, one sends a message, congratulation message. This should not happen. Unfortunately, it is. People are getting busy, and they don't have the time to enjoy family life. And this is bad. I think this is bad. And of course, the new technology played the major role in keeping families and friends far from each other. Mm-hmm. And as you rightly said, it's easier to send a message of congratulation or rather than drive for a couple of hours to go and see a family. So, but this again should, change. And I wish they cut the internet for just one day so that people are forced to go and see each other. Huh? Mm. Wishful thinking, of course.
Wishful thinking indeed, Dr. Raouf. Wishful thinking indeed. Dr. Raouf, this specific Eid, Eid al-Adha, or the festival of sacrifice, reminds us of the importance to obey commandments, to obey God's wishes and God's commandments. Do you see this as an opportunity for the religious discourse to focus on this issue, to remind people on the importance of peace and obedience to God's laws?
100%. It's not only the sacrifice. I mean, the whole Eid al-Adha is the ultimate obedience time.
Yes.
Because even the performance of al-Hajj with the different acts that are performed, whether staying on Arafah the day before the feast or going around the Kaaba seven times, three times, etc., etc., these are all ultimate obedience. Maybe we do not understand why seven times and not eight or not six. But this again, this is a test of ultimate obedience. So the whole theme of Eid al-Adha is circling around obedience. And this is very, very important because it is my belief that religion is something between the person and his God. Nobody interferes in the middle, but still it is very important to obey. And even without understanding, but it is important to obey. And Eid al-Adha, particularly the Feast of Sacrifice, is all about obedience. And I think that this is very, I should say, nourishing to the soul.
Yes.
Because we need, from time to time, spiritual thinking and this is the ultimate, I should say, spiritual mood that we put ourselves in, and we need to do that from time to time. And Eid al-Adha gives us the opportunity to do that.
Absolutely. Dr. Raouf Ghafr, our guest for this afternoon, thank you so much, sir, for joining us and for your insight. And once again, a very happy Eid to you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, doctor. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, we wrap up today's edition of Africa Today. We do hope you have enjoyed it. Many thanks for joining us.